Good morning, viewers. I'm grateful. I thank God for the final broadcast. He is a faithful God. Today, I just want to say hi to you, to welcome you, all of you, with this show of Morning with a King. This morning, we are going to be with a King, King Jesus. He is our King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. I want to welcome each and every one of us so that we can hear the word of God together, and God is going to bless us. We are going to share the word of God from the book of Hebrews, Hebrews chapter number 13, verse 8. Hebrews chapter number 13, verse 8. Bible says, Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forever. I repeat, Hebrews chapter number 13, verse number 8. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. May the Lord God, the Creator of the universe, bless His word this morning. I'm Bishop Dominion, and my message today is about thanksgiving. Thanksgiving. We are created to give thanks to the Lord. We are in December 2020. God has taken care of us. Today here in Kenya, he has lost a very important person, one of the governors from Nyamira County, John Ganyamara. We have lost this brother, our dear brother. And I want to send condolences to his family, and let us pray for his family so that God can strengthen them. But that is also a lesson of each and every one of us, that if you are alive, you need to give thanks to the Lord. Doesn't matter what you are going through, we are called to give thanks to the Lord. We are called to be thankful to God, to praise Him. That's why we were created. Unfortunately, sometimes the enemy will show us what we need, what we don't have, what we are lacking, and we fail to give thanks to the Lord. But this morning I want to encourage you, my brother, my sister, that we are called to thank God. We need to give thanks to the Lord for the fire that brought us. We are preparing for Christmas. But to me, I believe a true Christmas is giving thanks to the Lord for the fire that brought us. The Bible has told us, that we have learned from the book of Hebrews chapter number 13, verse 8, that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Number one, we need to thank God for yesterday. Yesterday, what God has done for you yesterday. If you can remember yesterday, if you are a record keeper, if you can keep a record of what God has done for you, what God has done in the past 2 years, past 1 year, 1 month, 1 week, yesterday. He is saying, Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. Yesterday, what God did to you, that one will give you a power. That one will give you power. It will encourage you to go before the Lord with thanksgiving. If you look back at your life, where you come from, those who are in USA, those who are in diaspora, remember where you came from. Yesterday, if you give yourself attention, if you reflect yourself, where you have come from, where you are, and what you are doing now, then you are going to give thanks to the Lord. You automatically know what Christmas meant to your life, because He is the same yesterday. In other words, yesterday He is the one who was with you. Remember David, when he faced Goliath, he remembered yesterday. He told Goliath, the God of heaven, when I was looking at my father's sheep, the lion used to come to destroy the sheep of my dad. But God of heaven, He normally gave me power. So he could remember yesterday. And when he remembered yesterday, he was able to face Goliath. You only face Goliath when you give thanks. Giving thanks to the Lord. for yesterday, for what you did yesterday. There are people who have been involved in accidents. You remember the accident that happened yesterday, 2 years ago, 3 years ago, 1 month ago. There's something that happened, and God, by His grace, He delivered you. You were sick. You went to the hospital. Today, you are alive. And people have gone to the hospital, and they are no more. They are not in sanctuary. They are in mortuary. You need to give God glory because of yesterday. The writer of Hebrews, which we believe is Paul, he is telling us today that the same Jesus, He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. So number one, if we reflect where we come from, if we reflect our yesterday, what God did yesterday. Remember in the book of John chapter 11, when Lazarus died and Jesus went there, and the Bible says he told the disciples and the mother who are there, open the door. When they opened that door where Lazarus was, the Bible says he looked up and he thanked God. He said, thank you, God, because always you hearken my prayer. Oh, yes, I prayed and you hearken my prayer. He was able to give thanks. Though Lazarus was dead, but Jesus started by giving thanks. Giving thanks because of yesterday will generate, will boost that power in you to give Him thanks. The power of thanksgiving. We give God because of yesterday. Not only yesterday. Don't forget what God did for you yesterday. Because of the needs that you have today. Sometimes we forget about yesterday because of the needs today. Let me tell you that the needs will never end. Always you will be in want. Always you will be in want. Maybe you need 1 million. If you get 1 million, you need 2 million. If you get a house, you need the second house. If you get a car, you need the second car. If you need a husband, if you get a husband, you need children. If you get children, you need something else. In other words, you keep on wanting. Because that's the life. But if you reflect where God has taken you, what God has given you, what God did yesterday, you'll be able to give thanks to Him. And for me, Christmas is all about thanksgiving. It's giving thanks to the Lord. It's reflecting what God has done to us. Even giving to the needy is okay. But more to that, it is reflecting where God has brought you. Go to the church. Look at the house of the Lord. And tell the Lord, I want to give thanks for yesterday. Not only yesterday. Remember, we have learned from the book of Hebrews, chapter 13, verse 8. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. You need also to give thanks to the Lord because of today. Today, God has done great things. You are alive today. You are powerful today. You are healthy today because He lived. Because He lived. So, the writer of Hebrews says, He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He is the same who is doing something new today. Remember today, God has great plans for us. We have woken up, all of us. There are people who went to sleep. There are people who went to work. There are people who went their duties as usual, but they never came back. But for you, God has given you power. You have woken up, those who are in Africa. You have woken up, those who are in diaspora. It is already night there. You are sleeping well. Those who are dwelling, you are energetic. Today you can give thanks to the Lord. You can open your mouth and give thanks to the Lord. Those who are in prison, those who are in hospital. Remember, there are those who are in mortuary. You are in hospital. But there are those who are in mortuary. You are in prison. But those who are in hospital. If you remember those things, you will be able to give thanks to the Lord today. So we give thanks to the Lord for today. For what God has done today, not only today, but forever, tomorrow, to forever his future. We give God for his future. How do we develop dancing, giving thanks to the Lord for his future, for our future? Because of his promises. Remember, God is not a man that he can lie. He is God, and above him there is none. He has promised a lot of promises in his word. He has promised that if we obey him, we shall eat the bread, we shall live a good life. Because of his promises, which are yes and amen, we need to give thanks to the Lord for yes and for tomorrow, for future. He has great future for us. Me, I know I want tomorrow. I want the future. Because future belongs to the Lord. Remember, you don't know how you woke up tomorrow. But if you can thank God for tomorrow, he will take care of tomorrow. If you thank God for 2021, he will take care of that year. If you thank God for 5 years to come, that he has got a great plan for you. You tell the Lord, I know where I need to be. I know where I am. I know where I'll be tomorrow. You thank God for tomorrow. Remember, in this king morning with a king, he is the same yesterday. He is the same today and forever. David used to say, I'm fearful and wonderful made. Because he knew, as Jeremiah says, that God has great plan for us. I know the plan I have for you, says the Lord. Plan to prosper you. Plan for great future. That plan we can thank God for you, for what he has done. Remember, we are talking of thanksgiving. We thank God for yesterday. We thank God for today. We thank God for future. Yesterday is what God has done. Today is what God is doing. Tomorrow is what God is going to do. That is Hebrews chapter 11, verse 8. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. This Christmas, my brother, my sister, remember to thank God. Remember to give him glory. Remember to have time with yourself. Separate yourself from people. Go somewhere. Take time. Tell the Lord, oh God, if it was not you who was on my side, the enemy could swallow me alive. If the Lord was not with us, the enemy could swallow us alive. But because God was with us, we are where we are. If it is not God who is not together with us today, we could not be where we are today. But because he is together with us, doesn't matter what the enemy is planning, doesn't matter who hates you or who loves you, as far as you have God in your life, you are going to go far. Remember, he has God's great plan for you. Out of 8 billion people, no one knows about you tomorrow, about your future. No one who can talk about your future. Even themselves, they don't know about tomorrow. But God, our Father, the creator of the universe, he knows us. He knows where you'll be tomorrow. He knows where you'll be tomorrow. He knows what he's about to do in your life. He knows about your family. Whatever is worrying you, God is taking care of it. Because you hold your future. Your fear cannot add anything in your life. You need to thank God for future. You thank God for tomorrow. Remember, Hebrews chapter 11, verse 8. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. This is a morning with a king. La Fifi TV, we love you as you give thanks to the Lord. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. Remember, we talk and we say, he is omnipotent God. He is omniscient God. He is omnipresent God. He is so powerful. He is everywhere. He is. He knows everything. That's why we need to thank him. Because he is the same yesterday, today, and forever. My brother, my sister, take time and thank God. Take time and give him glory. Give him thanks. Worship him with your song, with your substances, with what God has given him. Give him thanks. Take time and give him glory in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. If you feel you are blessed by this ministry, you are free to support us with your finances, with whatever God has given you. Support us. Our number is there. Everything is there. Support this ministry so that we can spread the gospel in a great way. On 22nd, we are on our way, with the remnant group, on Ethiopia County. We are heading to Ethiopia County to meet all the servants of God there. So you can support that mission, and God is going to bless you. But remember, Hebrews chapter 11, verse 8. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Thanksgiving. We thank God for yesterday, for today, and forever. That's all to do with Christmas. Christmas is reflecting ourselves. Where we were yesterday, where we are today, and where we are going. God bless you. Shalom, shalom. I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We love you. We love you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you. Shalom, shalom. Remember, this is Labit TV, a morning with the King. I am your servant, the servant of God, Bishop Dominion. God bless you. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you, mighty God. Yesterday, you take care of us, O God. You have been so faithful, O Lord. We are back on this mountain to give you glory, to give you honor, Lord. Thank you for my viewers, O God. Some of them, O Lord, were involved in accidents. They were in hospital, Lord. You took care of us, O God. They had enemy, my favorite demon. You fought for them, O God. Take all the glory. Take all the honor. Thank you for today. You have got great plan for each and every one of us, O God. All my viewers, O Lord, I pray, O God, that they are need you are going to meet them, Lord. Those who are sick, Lord, heal them today, O Lord. We thank you for the gift of life, for salvation of our soul, for your divine security, divine provision of our life. Thank you for tomorrow, Redeemer. Our life is in your hands, O God. We cannot reach tomorrow without you, Lord. We cannot face tomorrow without you, Lord. We cannot face 2021 without you, O God. We might have money, we might have everything, O God, but we need you, Jehovah God. I thank you, mighty God. Give you all the glory. Give you honor. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Remember, Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. Give him glory in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Shalom, shalom. God bless you. We love you.